Hey guys, I'm back again with another countdown video. Before this one starts, I'd just like to thank you all for participating in the poll. It seemed like a lot of you really liked the poll idea, so I'll keep doing it. But once again, I'd like to remind you guys that if you ever want me to stop doing the poll, you can tell me and I will get rid of it. With all that being said, let's get into the countdown that most of you guys voted for, which was the top 10 most botted areas on RuneScape. Also, keep in mind that there aren't that many bots left on old school RuneScape, and I'm not really sure about RS3 either, but that's due to Jagex's new botting detection software, but I still wanted to do this video anyway. So locations that you're seeing in this video might not have bots in them anymore, but at one point in time they were some of the most botted areas within the game. Also, don't forget to vote in the next poll for the next top 10 countdown video. Okay, let's get into it. Number 10, the flax fields. God, I already know there's gonna be so many spinning flax jokes in the comments. Anyway, the flax fields used to be quite popular back in the day and was up there on some of the most botted locations, though I can't figure out why anybody would want to do flax, but then again, you used to be able to literally bot for 6 days before the 6-hour automatic logout thing got to you. Oh, okay, let's go back in time. Let's say that this is 2006 RuneScape. There's no 6-hour logout timer, and you can literally bot for days and days. Say you're getting 600 flax per hour, right? Actually, no, let's say you got the top-of-the-line bot. Let's say that your cheating ass is topping out about 800 flax per hour, and you bot for 72 hours, so that's 3 days. That would be 57,600 flax. But you don't just sell this flax for 35 GP. No, you spend another 3 days spinning it all into 57.6k bowstrings, and then you sell all that for 125 GP each, okay? That would be 7.2 mil profit for you in about maybe 5 days, maybe six, maybe a week, I don't know. So basically you'll be ending up at 1 mil a day, ending up maybe 7.2 mil at the end of the week. Wow, that is 7.2 mil for a week. Wow. Now I can see why people wanted to bot flax. And you literally had to do nothing. You could just AFK for like days at a time. No. Don't bot. Botting is bad. I'm a YouTuber. I can't do this shit. Number 9, the willows near Drainer. Why? Why would you even bot willows, man, unless you're trying to get some serious fire-making gains, in which case you'd be burning all of your time and effort away as well as your money, or perhaps maybe you're botting willows because you're wanting that 60 or 70 woodcutting to go bot used later on, getting maybe like 54 U logs per hour or some shit like that, or just maybe you're botting willows simply for the XP and money, maybe getting 600 logs per hour for that 20 GP each, ultimately making your ending profit per hour 12k cash. Guys, literally, you can make 600k per hour with some skilling methods that take little to no effort. It's all AFKable. I don't know why people bought these willows, but they do, and it definitely deserves its place in the countdown. God, I remember when the default RuneScape character model would fill up the bank booths in Drainer. I mean, my God, they've already been robbed by the asshole across the street. Don't traumatize them further with your steel axes. Shit. Number 8, Mote Plox's living room. Aw, yeah, girl, that's right. Oh shit, sorry, wrong countdown video. The real number 8. Red Chinchapas. God, this used to be really irritating back in the days when I would train Hunter there. I actually trained Hunter to 99 before Black Chins were released and before Jagex laid down the long dick of the law on botters like they do today, literally after you bought for only like 5 minutes before getting permabanned. But the Red Chins were botted so much simply because of the money. If you had a decent Hunter level and you botted for days, you could literally have millions of mils, the real cash money dollars, in just like a couple of days sitting inside your bank. There were some legit people that actually hunted there, though, and it was so annoying trying to find a world to actually be able to get some good XP per hour rates if you were trying to get that 99. Nowadays, the chins aren't really botted that much, and if you go there, there's practically nobody there training. Maybe they're all doing black chins, I don't know. But back in the day, whoa, baby, 63 Hunter was what was in style back then, if you know what I'm saying. Number 7, the Rune Essence Mines. Look at this, man. Look at all this fail in the air right here. Look. The freaking names are Hoodoo Witch CHJ, Allium 2, and DSin 3 HQ, and Smelting Whore. Alright. Mote 103. Wait, Mote? That's fucking copyright. Sorry, lost the cool. But the cool's back. At least Ian up here at the top. Look at him. Look, what a visionary. Look, Ian had enough freaking respect for himself to go beyond the norms of the botting society and actually name his character Ian 424, and the 424 is probably April 24th or something, his birthday, I don't know. What a noob in all honesty, but hey, at least he's not cliche, like freaking Abui. These bots probably gave all their pure essence that they mined to their mains or something like that for runecrafting gains or GP gains or something. I think this picture was taken in like 2008, but God damn, they're probably all banned now anyway, so whatever. GG, Ian. Number 6, literally the whole town of Catherby? However you say it, I'm just going to call it Catherbot for the duration of the video. I think it's fitting. Anyway, in Catherbot, you have the fishing spot for those botting tubes who don't have 68 fishing yet to be able to get into the fishing guild. And then there's the west side of Catherbot where you got the noobs piling at the yew trees, getting them 54 logs per hour's gains, as I spoke up before, for their main accounts. Literally, though, I thought it was hilarious because I believe it was Will Missit. I think he has a video where Mod Weath is, like, going on a rampage, banning bots, poisoning them all, and their logs are just dropping on the ground. Free game for anybody who was around. It's pretty funny. But Catherbot is definitely one of the highest, most botted areas in RuneScape, or should I say once was, due to the fishing training to be able to go on to later into the guild, as well as the ewes that were so close to the bank just east of there. Number 5, agility. Everywhere, all the courses. Everybody hates agility, except for this guy, he loves the shit. But other than him, everybody hates agility, even though it can be quite useful. Agility, not really so much now, once again, but back in the past of OSRS, there were a lot of people who botted agility. Probably in RS3, mainly for the completionist cape or comp cape trim, whatever. Agility was definitely at one time one of the most botted skills within the game. Even though it doesn't get you any cash, it did make getting around RuneScape to be able to bot in other areas for those independent enough to be able to create their own botting scripts a lot easier. Intelligent noobs, man, I'm telling ya. Number 4, in RuneScape 3, this video was filmed on 2011 down in the mining guild in the Dwarven Mines. Look at all these freaking bots, man. How do you even get ores? Like, seriously, I bet they're all getting one piece of coal every freaking 10 minutes if they're lucky. Like, what was the point of this? Like, seriously, all that happened to you was that you were banned. You didn't get no coal. You just botted for the hell of it, getting nothing. This video was quite interesting when I found it, and the music in the background of this video was a 10 out of 10 would watch again masterpiece for me. There's also a part 2 where he shows what happened after a bot nuke took place. Everybody got banned. GG, your 10 coal that you got in those 6 hours. But anyway, I've left the full link to the video in the description. Oh, and look, all the bots stop for a 2-second rest whenever they're done mining ores. What the actual fuck? Number 3, the Turoth Slayer monsters that live down in the caves of Nreleka. This area is probably botted a lot because of the drops you get from these things, and plus they're not really that hard to kill. There's not much bots there anymore nowadays, but back in the day, Turoths were mainly killed for the seeds and herbs that they drop. They drop all high-level seeds like snapdragons and ranars, as well as the high-level herbs quite often. They also drop leaf-bladed swords and mystic robes that could go for a nice price amongst players as well. They'll also drop coins anywhere from 44 coins to like 440 coins, I think, which is a pretty common drop too amongst them. And I suppose if you want to work Slayer into it, then I guess you could. There's a perfectly good way to bot Slayer too, as they give 70 to 80 XP per kill depending on their combat levels. Number 2, the Rogue's Den, where players train cooking. Just recently I was at the Rogue's Den, actually, where I saw Mod Archie hanging out there, and perhaps maybe he was looking to see who was actually botting down there or something, I don't know. But he turned into a bush right before he logged out, so there's definitely some suspicious shit going on, I'd assume. Anyway, the Rogue's Den, a popular botting spot. Mainly people used it for sharks. Skilling's actually quite profitable in RuneScape, and believe it or not, even though it's quite newbie, you can actually make quite a bit of profit off of cooking sharks. If you buy like 10k raw sharks right now for like 800 GP each, and then cook them all, sell them all for maybe 1100 GP each, that's like going from 8 mil that you spent right there to 11 mil. I'm pretty sure there are still bots located in this place, however I can't say for sure because I don't know what with all the new bots getting owned nowadays immediately. Number 1, the Green Dragons. Now this place I'm sure of still has bots, I know it does. I went there just recently after the poll results were looking pretty clear on which video you guys wanted to see, and I saw tons of bots there when I did go there, and I actually used to go there and freeze the bots with my friends and take all their dragon bones and hides, and it was some seriously good cash, actually. Huh, I need to start doing that again. Hey, if any of you ever want to go kill some bots with me, and, I don't know, report them, try to become P-mods or something, let me know, let's do it. I'm just kidding. They're not really worth the time and effort, but seriously though, why would you bot green dragons? Get you some void, get you some patient balls, I mean, get you some patience and some balls, and get you 70 agility, and just camp down at the blue dragons, dude. It's practically AFKable, and you don't have to worry about PKers, and it's better money. You can safe spot it and pretty much don't even need an anti-dragonfire shield. Seriously, man, botters, they really honestly do things the hard way. In all honesty, a legitimate person is probably more faster and efficient than a bot is, but the only downside is that the bots just go for longer periods of time than we do. which is why it seems like they make a lot more. If you're thinking about botting, trust me, it's not worth it. You'll feel better about yourself and learn more about the game over time as a whole to be able to manipulate the time spent on tasks around the game and such. Learn how to AFK instead of botting because it's completely legal. That's it for this countdown. God, I was in a good mood when I made this one. Thank you guys for voting in the poll. Sorry for me being kind of silly in this one and I didn't take it very seriously as much. Next countdown will be out soon. Don't forget to vote in the next poll for the next video. Also, I'd like to ask you guys something real quick. Post it in the comments. For 10,000 subscribers, a lot of you are wanting me to do a Q&A video about myself since you guys really don't know much about me. If you want me to do a Q&A video, ask me some questions then down in the comment section because you guys are cool like that and we'll probably be at 10,000 subs within a few days. So thank you guys already for 9,000 subscribers. Thanks for the suggestions. I will see you guys later.